Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to the Social.in channel. This week on the Social Media Weekly, we're talking about Facebook sending a letter to Clearview.ai. We're talking about Google getting into trouble with the European Union again. And we're talking about Google Photos sending your private videos to complete strangers. Let's get started. So the first story we have for you today is about a bug in Google Photos which happened between November 21st and November 25th, 2019, which sent private photos of Google Photos users to complete strangers. It happens to users who used Google Takeout service, a service which Google engineered so that people could download their data from Google Photos because they were concerned about privacy. Anyway, so this bug apparently affected 0.01 of Google's over 1 billion users for Google Photos. You can find out if you were affected when Google sends you an email. There is a link to the article in the description below, right next to that like button. The next story we have here today is about Google getting into trouble with the European Union again because of their location tracking. So the Irish Data Protection Commission, Never Cross an Irishman, has sent an investigation to Google because they track users' location. They have also sent an investigation to Match.com's Tinder because they are using users' personal information for their own nefarious purposes. Anyway, it turns out that in 2018, even if a user turned off Google's location tracking, Google was still tracking their location. And there's a lot more information that can be gained about you than simply where you are by tracking your location. For example, if you know that every day I come from home to work, there's a pretty good chance that I'm working at social.in. There's a link to the article in the description below. Our next story has to do with Google's Jigsaw, which has launched a new tool to help journalists do their job better. So Google Jigsaw, which was formerly known as Google Ideas, has launched a new tool called the Assembler, which uses 7 tests in order to identify whether a photo is a deepfake or not, whether it's been altered using artificial intelligence or not. So this tool is not available to public, obviously, because Google doesn't want people to game the system, but it is available to journalists and news organizations all over the world who can use this tool to fight fake news. Our next story has to do with everyone's favorite social network, Facebook.com. So Facebook is shutting down their Facebook Audience Network for mobile web, not for mobile apps. Facebook Audience Network is similar to Google AdSense, where it allows publishers of mobile apps and mobile websites to show ads on their websites powered by Facebook's data. Anyway, so Facebook is shutting this down because they're saying that there's not enough demand for it. But it is most likely because Google Chrome will soon stop tracking using third-party cookies for ad targeting. Also, Safari and Firefox have already blocked all of this third-party cookie tracking. Facebook Audience Network will continue to live on for the mobile app ecosystem. And by the way, eMarketer said that last year in the US, $17 billion was spent on mobile web ads, but $81 billion was spent on mobile app ads. Our final story of the day has to do with the pot calling the kettle black. So there is a company called Clearview AI, which uses artificial intelligence in order to scrape publicly available information from social media websites such as Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube, and Google, and create a facial recognition database. The startup currently has 3 billion images and has used this database only for lawmakers. Indeed, last month, there was a case where the Indiana State Police used this information in order to solve an important case. Anyway, Facebook has sent a letter to Clearview asking them to stop data harvesting. It's outrageous that Facebook is outraged about another company collecting your data. That's about it for this week's episode, guys. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And as you know, we're obsessed with that. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment section down below. Subscribe to the Social.in channel on YouTube. Ring that notification bell so that you never miss a video. And we will see you guys in the next week's episode.